Hello class 11, this is your chemistry class and we are discussing about the postulates of PACPR theory. So let's continue the class. So last theory, last postulates of PACPR theory is rule number 5. So what does it predict? Rule number 5 is saying about the answer electron pair or central atom having incomplete valence or causes greater repulsion, which results in significant contraction in bond angle. Okay, so it is saying about that if I again write about AX and here exist lone pair of electrons, the unshared electron pair or central atom having incomplete valence shell causes greater repulsion. So suppose this one is AX2 and this one is BX2. Okay. So, if I say the for this central atom A, the valence shell have also exist lone pair of electrons. If I compare the valence shell electrons of A and B, and if I say that for B, the valence shell is not fulfilled, okay, incomplete valence shell. This central atom B has incomplete valence shell. Okay, then the occupation of space of this non-bonding electron pairs will be more in this case. Okay, so though both AX2 and BY2 both have similar geometry, but the difference is in the nature of the central atom. So depending on the nature of the central atom, when the central atom has incomplete valence shell, then this lone pair of electron that is present over the central atom will occupy more space. Okay, so if I have drawn the structure of this AX2 lone pair of electron like this, so if B has incomplete valence shell, so this lone pair of electron can occupy more space over the central atom. So the unshared pair of electron or central atom having incomplete valence shell will causes greater repulsion, which results in significant contraction in bond angle. So as soon as it occupies more space, obviously this lone pair bond pair repulsion increases when it occupies more. As soon as the occupation of space increases, the repulsive factor, steric factor will also increase, right? So increase in size means steric factor, repulsive factor, repulsion factor will increase. So if we compare this and this, due to the incomplete valence shell, this lone pair of electron is occupying more space, and that's why the repulsive factor here is higher. This repulsion is higher than this repulsion. Okay, here also exists repulsion and here also exists repulsion, but due to the more occupation in space, this repulsion is higher. So here bond angle will also be lower. Though the geometries are same, bond angle in BX2 will be lower. So if we just explain with one example, like PH3 and H2S. So the bond angles are reduced to 94 degree and 92 degree. We can compare. So for example, compare also PH3 and NH3. Okay, if you compare PH3 and NH3, they are having the structures like this, PH3 and NH3. So both are having one lone pair of electrons, but their occupation of space will be different. So in NH3, if lone pair occupies this much space, then in phosphorus it will occupy more space. Okay, more space, you know that you can also incomplete valence shell, you can also compare it with the size factor. You can also compare with the size factor. So in the periodic table, this one is group 15. So in periodic table, in group 15, if you go downwards, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth in group 15. So on going down the group in group 15 or any group, actually size increases. So on going from nitrogen in phosphorus, size increases. So as soon as size increases, the occupation of space of this lone pair of electron also increases, and when this space occupation increases, this repulsive factor increases and the bond angle squeezes, okay, it decreases. So here in PH3, the bond angle is 94 degree, okay, this one is very low, 94 degree, and in ammonia, you know, this one is 107 degree. Both are tetrahedral, okay, geometry are same, both are tetrahedral. Ammonia is 107 degree, somewhat lower than 109 degree due to lone pair bond pair repulsion, but here the similar geometry, both are group 15 elements, still the bond angle in PH3 it is 94 degree, because this the occupation of this lone pair electron, space occupation is higher here, and that's why it's imparting more repulsion and squeezing the bond angle to 94 degree. So you can compare, these are much different, okay. So in this way you can compare the bond angles by comparing the size or the incomplete valence shell of the atoms, okay. So all the rules of BSAPF theory actually completed. Next class we will study about, we will learn how to find the structures, that is, as we are saying, this one is tetrahedral, okay. So how can we find that PH3 and NH3 both are tetrahedral, both are having sp3 hybridization. So next class we will study about hybridization and how to find the shapes and structures of different molecules. Okay.